Welcome to an animation of a line in the form y equals mx plus b. The goal of the video is to illustrate how changing the value of m and b change the graph of a line in slope-intercept form. And just to refresh your memory, if a line is in the form y equals mx plus b, m equals the slope of the line and b equals the y-intercept of the line. So here we see a line graphed on the coordinate plane. And here we see the equation of the line. So the current line has slope 0.321. First thing I'm going to do is change the value of the slope and leave the y-intercept the same. And I'd just like you to watch how the line changes as we change the slope. Okay, I'm going to pause the line here. Now what I want you to notice is the slope is positive, it's 0.481, and as I increase the slope, the line becomes more slanted or more steep. Another thing I'd like you to notice is if the slope is positive, the line does go up from left to right. So moving from left to right, the line is going up. And again, as we increase the slope, the line goes up even faster from left to right. Let's pause the line here for a moment. Here we can see our slope is approximately 3, or 3 over 1. Remember, what that means is if we pick a point on the line, to find another point on the line, we'd have to go up approximately 3 units and over 1. So if I change the slope to, let's say, 6, or roughly 6, that means I'd have to go up 6 and right 1 to find another point on the line, which makes the line much more steep than when the slope is equal to 3. So if I increase it to 9, picking a point on the line, we'd have to go up 9 units and right 1. So as the slope increases, the line becomes more steep from left to right. Now as we decrease the slope, the line will become less slanted, and what I want you to do is watch once it turns negative. Once the slope turns negative, you'll notice the line is slanted down from left to right. So negative slopes will slant down from left to right, and as we decrease the slope further, you can see it becomes slanted down even more. So if I pause here and look at the slope of negative 3, if I pick a point on the line, I'd have to go down 3 units and right 1 to find another point on that line. If I change the slope to negative 6, using the same idea, I'd have to pick a point and now go down 6 units and right 1 to find another point on the line. So it becomes even steeper downhill from left to right. The last thing I want to point out, notice that if the slope is 0, we have a horizontal line, and the x term disappears from our equation, we have y equal to a constant. Okay, let's go ahead and take a look at the effect of changing the value of b, or the y-intercept. Notice how changing the value of b does not change how the line is slanted. It just shifts the line up or down. So if we pause here for a moment, notice that the y-intercept is approximately positive 3, and that is exactly where the line crosses the y-axis. If I pause at approximately b equal to 1, we have a y-intercept of 1. If we pause here, the value of b would be approximately negative 2. And we have a y-intercept of approximately negative 2, and so on. So the value of b will give us the y-intercept of the line, and it does not affect how the line is slanted. That's controlled by the slope. I hope you found this animation helpful.